Maps. What are maps and type of maps? Now, we learned about the globe, right, in some of our earlier videos. And this globe basically gives you an indication in terms of various pieces of land which are there, various countries which are there, right, and everything else. Now, this is useful when you have to study about Earth. Right? When you have to study about Earth, globe is a useful measure because you can easily see the entire globe to see what places is where. But consider this. We have a small person. Let me call him Ram. He has to go to a place where his aunt stays, and he travels by roads, and these roads are something like this. Right? As he started from his house, okay, he got down to a car maybe, and this car kept on moving. Right? On his way, he saw various trees. There were some mountains as well. And as he was about to reach his aunt's place, he realized that there was an overbridge from which a river was flowing. And I'm sure this is a situation which many of you would have seen. Right? Making one more trip. Now, if Ryan wants to know how does he reach his aunt, there are certain things which he needs to know. First thing is, what is the direction he should be following, right? And what is the landscape? I mean, even if I said before, what is the landscape of this particular thing? When I draw all these things, this is something which is called a map. So this might be the actual thing, but if I draw it on paper, right, represent the surface of the earth, how the earth is. There are mountains over here, there are trees over here, there's a river over here, and all these things, right? So when we represent all these things on a piece of paper, that piece of paper is called map. Now obviously, if let's say for example this distance was 10 miles, I cannot make a map of 10 miles. Maybe I'll make it 10 centimeters, right? And what will I say? I will say that, okay, for every 1 mile, I will represent it by 1 centimeter on the map. This is called the scaling, which is nothing but how much of actual land, which is 1 mile, is represented on the map, which is 1 centimeter. This is known as the scale of the map, right? Now, most of these maps are divided into various categories. Let's talk about them. The first one is the physical map. Right? So what does a physical map do? The physical map is going to tell you as to what are the features of the Earth. Features of Earth. When I say features of the Earth, something which is naturally there on Earth. Of course, there are changes which might have been made by man. So let's say for example trees. This is something which is available. Mountains, rivers. So a physical map basically shows you the natural features of the Earth. Something like a mountain, something like trees, something like rivers, and all the other places. The second type of map that you have is a political map. Now this has nothing to do with politics, right? But what it shows is, what are the various cities, towns and villages? So let's say Ram was living in a town called A. So town A is where Ram lived. As he took a left turn, there was a place here which was called village B, right? Then here you have a city D. So a political map basically shows these towns, villages, cities and all those things. So if I look at a political map, it will show you town, village, city. So if you want to have a look at this particular thing, please ignore this particular stuff. So let's say a political map will show you that, okay, you have place A here, you have city B here, you have village D here. It is only going to show you the city and places, no mountain, no trees, no things like that. Whereas if we talk about a physical map is going to show you that, okay, we have some trees over here, there's a river which flows, at this place, this is the road which is there, right? As we go here, you have mountains. So a physical map shows you these natural features of the earth. A political map shows you only the cities and everything. Of course, there will be certain other details also. There could be an overlap also. And then the last one that we have is something which is called a thematic map. Now these are basically based on particular themes, right? So let's say, for example, if you had a thematic map, you have, let's say, region 1, region 2 and region 3. Let's say we take a thematic map of rainfall. This map will tell you that in this particular region, the rainfall is 100 centimeter. Right? Here it is 150. Here it is 75 cubic meter. Centimeter is not the same one which we have in inches and all. It's cubic meter. Right? So these are the thematic maps showing a particular theme. Let's say rainfall. Right? It could be roads. Or any other thing. Themes is what thematic map shows. Right? I hope you would have understood this particular thing. So maps basically is what? It is nothing but the representation of the actual earth figures on a piece of paper which has a scale which shows how much of land is covered by per centimeter or per measurement of the map. Right? The maps could be physical, it could be political, it could be thematic. Physical, it shows the natural features of the earth. Political, shows town, villages and cities. And thematic, shows particular themes like rainfall, roads, etc. Thank you for being with us today.